Higher. Lock it all the way up. Get up. No. Higher. Get all the way up to the top. There you go. Now rotate your shoulders in.
This is a good instruction too.
Swimmers. We're filming underwater to show different drills that we're doing, putting them out of the CD thing and let me use the swimmers. Guy was getting ready to go to the national championships, and I said, I see something. Should I talk to him? I really don't want to talk to him this close to me. He goes, it's you. Go ahead. Really, no problem. So we did. We told him. He was pulling. He began his pull nice and straight. Elbow was high. See that? It's fine. But it's not. You're not very strong this way. You're way stronger when you rotate that shoulder in. Now you're much stronger. It's so subtle, you can't see it. Oh, I was going to try to tell you a thing. I was going to tell you a bit. So high elbow. Push. Again. We're doing one rep at a time. That's all. So this is sort of like the lever here. We're just looking for one rep power. Ready? So what we used to do on our team is go through the circuits. We had a lot of people. Go through the circuit. We can run 20 people through here because only 10 are on machines. Easily. We have 35 or something we can do all at the same time and then come back. Like on this one, you can't do leg extension at the same time you leg curl because somebody's on the machine. There's too many people. And then we would come back and we would do certain ones for certain people. But everybody had to end with whatever time they swim in the 400 IM, they had to challenge and they had to do better. And I challenged that swimmer that went 352, and he was like, 430, 440, which is still pretty good for a 13-14 boy, right? 430, 440 when we started. But we would do this thing, pull over. We modified a Nautilus machine. We pulled over, and we locked it up so it couldn't really crank them out. And then we just did the best job we could on that. I was dying, but I didn't tell him that. We got to like 165 pounds in his time for the